हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सॉल्व लीटकोड प्रॉब्लम नंबर 49, ग्रुप एनाग्राम्स। सो फर्स्ट वी विल अंडरस्टैंड द प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट, आफ्टर दैट वी विल सी अप्रोच फॉर दिस प्रॉब्लम, एंड एट द एंड वी विल सी कोड इन जावा।
लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड द क्वेश्चन। सो द क्वेश्चन सेज दैट वी हैव गिवन एसटीआर स्ट्रिंग्स, मींस एरे ऑफ स्ट्रिंग्स, एंड वी नीड टू ग्रुप ऑल द एनाग्राम्स इन वन list. So anagram is a word or a phrase formed by arranging the letters of the different words or phrase. Let's see what is anagram. So anagram is, we have given eat and tea. So rearranging e to this place and a to e place, then it will form eat. So it is called anagram. Let's see example one. So we have given eat, tan, ate, nat, and bat. So we have eat here. So we will group this into one group, and remaining tan, nat. So this one is other group, and bat is third group. So we can see that this is in one array list, this is in another array list, this one and this one, and this one groups are in another array list. This is how we need to group all the anagrams into the list. So now let's understand the approach. Here I have taken one small example and I have mapped the A to 0, B to 1. So we are converting that into numbers. After that, we have these steps. Count each character of strings. Second step, from counted character, we need to make unique key, and in that we will add our anagrams. So let's see this example. We have A, B. So we have A is mapped with 0. So we will take 0, and its count is 1 because we have just visited this. After that we have B. B value is 1. So we will count is also 1. Then we will iterate through 0 to 25 and make the unique key. So for AB, we will make unique key. So it will be at 0 we have count 1, so we will add 1 with hash. After that, at 1 we count 1, so I will add 1. We not have 2, then it by default it will be 0. If we not have that count, then it will 0. It will end at 25 and with 0. Same for the BA also. So BA have value 1, here we can see 1, so I will add 1, and current counter is 1 for this string, so 1. After that we have A value is 0, so its counter is also 1, so I will again generate the key. So BA, for BA we have A for 1, we have count 1. For B, we have count 1. For 2, we have count 0. So on, we do not have count for 25 also. So as we can see, we have this two same keys. So we can group these two anagrams into one. So it will look like A, B, B, A. So it is one pair of anagram we have. After that we will check for other AC. So A have 0 value and counter is 1. C have 2 value and counter is 1 because this is new string. So we will generate key for AC. So A have 1 count, 1 have 0 count because 1 is not present. 2 have 1 count, 4 have 0 count, so on we till with 25 we don't have any count, so we will keep at 0. So for AC, we can see that AB and BA are not same as AC. So we will group it into another group of list. So it will be AC. Now we will check CA. So for C, we have 2. For A, we have 0. And both of these counters are 1 because this is new string. So we will create this CA unique key for CA. So it will be at 0, we have 1 count. At 1, we have no count, so it will be 0. For 2, we have 1 count. For 3, we have no count till 25. So as we can see, these both are same keys we have generated. So it will be in this group. Same key are in same group. So it will be in this anagram group. So this is our final answer. Now we will understand why we are adding hash here in another example. Let's see why we are using hash to generate unique key. So here I have taken example B and 10 times D, and here 10 times B and 1 times C. Then here B value is 1, then count is also 1, and D value is 3 and count is 10. So value is from that I have written from A to Z, we have 0 to 25. So that are the values. From that, the B value is 1 and count is 10. From here we can see, and C value is 2 and count is 1. So without hash, if we generate from 0 to 25, means iterating over the characters of 0 to 25 in numbers, then we will get A count is 0 here, so it is 0. After that we have B, then B is 1. After that we have C. C is not available in this first example, so we have 0. After that we have D, its count is 10, then we have 10. After that E is not present, then we have keep all as 0 till 25. So now we will, just for simplicity, we are concentrating on this part. So in second B equal to 1 value and count is 10, so we don't have A, so A value is 0 and B equal to 10, so we have B 10 count, so we have added here. After that we have C value is 2 and count is 1, so we have added 1 here count of C. After that D is not there, then we have put 0 all over till 25. So from this we can see that this both are generated same key, but they have different characters. As we can see from the example, we have B and D's, and here we have B's and 1C, so they are not equal, as we can see. So because of that we have added hash in between. This is how we generate unique with using hash. Now let's see time and space complexity for this solution. So time complexity will be O of n into k, where n is length of array strings, because we are iterating over the each string and counting the characters. So this is for iterating over the array, and k is for iterating over each string to count the characters. And our space complexity will be O of n k. This is the total data stored in the map.
So now let's understand the solution. Here I am checking the condition. If array is empty, means no string is present in the string of arrays, then I am returning the empty list. After that I have created hash map string. It will be the unique keys, and the list of strings means anagrams. After that I have int count is 26 that we are taking from 0 to 25, assigning to the characters. Here for loop is for iterating to the array strings, and here I am filling initializing the count equal to 0 for different strings, means 0 to 25, 0 initialized. So here I am iterating to the character by character string and storing the counters for that. Here we are getting like C is our, if C is our A, then A minus A will be 0, means in ASCII they convert and convert it into 0, means A is ASCII value is 97, so it will be 97 minus 97, it will be 0. So incrementing the counter, after that incrementing the counter for all the characters of that string, after that iterating to the 0 to 25 to generate the unique key. So here I am generating the unique key, appending the hash after that value that we had counted, after that converting the key into string because we have appended into string builder, checking if that key is present in hash map. If it is not present, then we are initializing it with the empty list. If it is present, adding into the existing list that string, and at the end I am returning the values of the map and converting into array list and returning the answer. Thank you for watching my video. Please like and subscribe to my channel because it motivates me to create more videos.